Let's meet Neil, one of our top 20 finalists of Whitblock's Young Inventor TechFest 2020.
Hello friends, my name is Neil Mehta and I am from Billabong High International School, Thane, and I study in grade 6. I love to explore new trends in the field of electronics and technology, and in my free time, I also try my hands on some culinary skills. So you saw the light is turned on automatically.
Hi Neil.
Hi.
Let's go for lunch, Neil.
Friends, you saw when I entered the room, there was some level of darkness, so the light turned on automatically. When my father entered the room, we were two people inside the room and the light remained on. When my father went for lunch, I was only left in the room, so still the light remained on. Finally, when I went out for lunch, the light turned off automatically as there was no one in the room. So this saves energy and money without any effort. Likewise, many people can enter the room and the light will still remain on. Finally, when the last person steps out of the room, the light will be turned off automatically. So friends, don't you worry. We can always switch off the light at night while sleeping, even if we are inside the room, by turning off the LED. So friends, the benefits of this project are: first, it saves energy and money. Second, in this project we are not using any Alexa or Google Duo, in which we need to tell a phrase or sentences for turning on and off lights. And this is also good for elderly people, so they don't need to remember or say any phrase or sentences to the Alexa and Google Duo. Third, this can also be used in meeting rooms in corporates. Fourth, I have also tuned the dark sensor, so the light will only be turned on when there is some darkness in the room. Fifth, this project doesn't need any Wi-Fi or Bluetooth. Yay, the light is turned off as I moved out of the room. Let's see the technical part. So I have used one Arduino Uno for controlling the whole project, one 9-volt battery which is powering up the Arduino Uno, one 5-volt relay which is controlling the LED plate. This is the main switch for the whole project. I have also tuned the dark sensor, and this is the most important sensors, which is the ultrasonic sensor for detecting the in-out movement. This is the 12-volt LED plate. So you can see, there are just a handful of components and Eureka! Our solution is ready to use. Thank you.
Welcome, Neil. And I would request all our judges to ask questions to Neil regarding the project. Thank you.
A great presentation, Neil. How are you detecting
the sound?
How can you tell if how many person entered the room and how many person exited the room? How is the state management?
Yes, so I am using two ultrasonic sensors. So I have named it like in sensor and out sensor. So when the in sensor detects any object, I give a delay of 1.5 seconds. And I have also coded a count variable, and upon this action, the count variable is incremental. So that means that there is one person in the room. Same with the out sensor. When the out sensor detects any object, I give a delay of 1.5 seconds and it decrements the count variable because the person has left the room.
So what if I stand in front of the sensor for say 2 seconds, then the in sensor would also detect me and the out sensor would detect me as well. What happens in that case? So just tell me, so, for example, if you try it 10 times, how many times does it work as it should?
Yes, yeah. If we try for like 10 times, it will work, but the count will be incremented and decremented like that.
Okay. And do you plan on doing anything, do you plan on using a different sensor, for example, to make it more accurate? Have you thought of that?
Yes, I plan to use motion sensors. So like, I plan to use motion sensors, so it will just detect the human movement and not any other object.
Neil, well done. I like the way that you've looked at a problem and broke it down and came up with a solution. Have you got other ideas for the next problem you're going to solve?
I am still thinking about any other problem that community has, and I'm thinking of an idea.
Good. Well, good success with it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Neil, good presentation, and the fact that you did put in the counter is something which is very nice and well thought out. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Sujit, sir, your mic is you are not audible actually. Not yet.
I think there's some issue.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Sorry. Yeah, my mic was off. Sorry. Yeah, very nice presentation, Neil. And what I was trying to say is that if you have two sensors very close to each other, there will be a overlap of what they see, right? Isn't it? So how did you take care of that overlap? How did you take care of that overlap?
So I didn't keep the sensors very close to each other. I kept a distance of, I think, 2.5 centimeter. So this overlapping problem doesn't happen. That's all.
Okay. Okay, good.
Many, many congratulations to Neil for his invention. On behalf of the entire team of Witblocks and TechFest, we wish him the very best of luck for the future.